Welcome back to Getting Started with Coda iOS. Let's take a look at Coda's file browser. Before we begin, you should already have created at least one site to connect to. If you haven't yet, check out the first video in this Getting Started with Coda iOS series. Okay, onward. The file browser in Coda iOS is split between a local view, which shows documents on your device, and a remote view, which shows what's on the server or another device, such as your Mac. See our video, Coda iOS, Transfer Files from Your Mac, for more information. On iPhone, you can see one view at a time. With an iPad, you can choose to see them side by side. Nice. Move files around by dragging them down to the bottom of the screen on an iPhone, or dragging them directly between local and remote folders on iPad. You can set your view options here. You can sort your files by name, size, kind, or date, and choose whether they're arranged in ascending or descending order. Toggle switches for display preferences too. Hit Done, and then just tap on a folder to open it, or tap on a file to see more info and options for it. Keep in mind, these options will be slightly different for certain types of files, and you'll have different options for local files, like upload, export, and compress. But before we hit Edit in Coda to open this remote file, let's have a look at everything here. You can move this file to another folder, duplicate it, or delete it. You can download it so that it will show up locally on your device. You can copy the path of your file, or the tag, which is super helpful, or even the URL once it's published. And you can easily see the file's permissions and change them right here. Okay, now let's get to work by tapping Edit in Coda. Great, so here's what the editor looks like. You can learn all about how to make the most of it in the next video in this series. For now, I want to point out a few things. See this little number 1 in the upper left here? That represents the number of documents you currently have open in tabs. Tap it to see what they are. On an iPad, all of your tabs will be visible up here at the top, so you won't have to tap to see what you have open. And on both iPad and iPhone, the Files button here will take you back to your current directory. Tapping the plus button will let you open a new tab, which can be a new document, a browser preview, a terminal session, or a playground, which lets you load and test JavaScript files. We'll cover the terminal and playground later in this video series. Finally, this grid icon is the Sites button. It'll take you back to the Sites view. So that's the file browser in Coda iOS. Be sure to watch the rest of the videos in this Getting Started series to become a Coda iOS expert in no time. For more information, visit panic.com.